I've always had an interest, you know, in singing since I was really young. You know, listening to the radio, been really influenced by Mariah Carey. I love her melodies. She's a great songwriter. Whitney Houston, of course. I like real old bluesy music, too, you know, real soulful music, like down in New Orleans where I'm from.
When I was little, I didn't say, you know, I'm gonna be a superstar, this is what I'm gonna do, but I was always doing shows. My friends would come over and we'd make these big shows and I was so serious about it, you know, and I was the director and we would do stuff like that all the time. And then, you know, when I grew out of that stage, then I just got really involved with just listening to music all the time.
When I was 8 years old, I began singing, and I went to the Mickey Mouse Club. I did that. It was with a bunch of kids. It was a lot of fun. And I came to New York and I did an off-Broadway musical called Ruthless. I met an entertainment lawyer. He sent me to New York when I was 15 at the time. And I was so nervous, you know, and I got up in front of, you know, a bunch of his executives at Jive, and I sang and they signed me. So that's how I'm here today.
She's got an excellent voice. It's it's actually quite, you know, what I heard in the Backstreet Boys, that they had, you know, excellent voice with a bit flavor in it. You know, a good sense of, you know, catching the melody, performing it, taking it to another level. Because that's, as a songwriter, that's what you're looking for. You do a song that sounds good, and then if the artist can take that to another level, you know, that's the perfect thing, that's the perfect situation.
Making my first record is great, yeah. It's a lot of fun, and people really don't realize what, you know, work goes into it.
We should actually record the second hook on the chorus.
Yeah, so that it works.
So we know that it works.
What?
We were thinking of recording it after the breakdown, just to have, but we should record where we have the
Max chorus. Is as nice as he is talented. He's really a great guy, and I'm very thankful to be able to work with him. He's great. And in Sweden, we went there, and it was really busy. We went there for 10 days. We got a lot done, and it was just great. We just, you know, went in there and sang it. It felt good.
The way I work is to have a good song, you know. It always has to be good songs, because without that, you know, you can't do anything. You know, like I said about her voice, to have some flavoring, it's like straight pop music with a flavor, you know. What we call R&B in Sweden, what you guys say is pop here.
My style of music is pop. I love pop music, just, you know, fun, and I love funky, hard beats, you know. Of course I love ballads, you know, I love ballads, but I love stuff that I can perform well and get on stage and dance and have fun and get the audience into it.
The album, I think, is going to be very easy to understand, although sort of the vocals is going to be not like... I say technically that's going to be great, you know. It's not going to be like a sing-along easy record, da-da-da-da, like that, but the songs are pop and the vocals are soul, you know, soulful, I think.
Soda Pop is such a fun song. When you hear it, you're just like, oh, I want to go outside and just, you know, party. It's like a really fun summer song. Everyone, you know, just in your car listening to, you know, it's a great song. It's a lot of fun. From the Bottom of My Broken Heart is talking about two couples, you know, that have been apart, you know, and always, that she's always going to love him, you know, no matter what, you know, and he was her first love, you know, and, just something that, you know, she'll always remember him and always love him. Email My Heart is like a song everyone can relate to, you know. Everyone has been doing emails and it's Email My Heart, so it's everyone can relate to that song. Sometimes is a very nice song. It's really sing-along, you know, everyone can sing along to it, and it's just a really easy, laid-back, cool song. Me Baby One More Time. It's a real funky attitude song, you know, everyone can sing along to. It's a lot of fun to sing. I like the type of music I'm singing because it's pop and you can have attitude, you know, and be funky. So my album is mainly focused toward just funky and fun, happy sing-along music.